announce to you today that all your battles have been decided by God in your favor. You see, everything you're going through, God has decided the outcome, and God has posted the outcome. And the outcome is that you're going to be victorious. The outcome is that you're going to be healed. You're going to be healed. The outcome is that you're going to win. The outcome is that victory is going to be your name. The outcome is you're going to have a testimony. Glory to God. So every challenge you're going through in life, the results have been posted. God has posted all the result. And the result is that you win. The result is that you're going to conquer. The result is that you're going to overcome. And the result is that you're going to dominate and rule. Glory to God. And I want you to receive this word today, because this is going to come to pass in your life. You're going to receive it by faith. It doesn't matter how tough and hard it looks. God is saying, I have posted the result, and the result is victory. Glory to God. See, Isaiah chapter 43 and verse 1, the Bible says, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine. So fear not, for the outcome of every battle you are in now has been released. The outcome is that you're going to win. You're going to be victorious. Glory to God. He said, fear not. Don't be agitated. Don't be fearful. Don't be afraid. You will not lose. You will not die. You will not be destroyed. You will not be put to shame. You will not be neglected. God is saying, I'm going to give you victory. I'm going to sustain you. I'm going to redeem you. I'm going to bring you out. I'm going to launch you into my divine purpose. Glory to God. God is telling you today, I want to receive it by faith. You are mine. I've planned your deliverance even before you get into the fight. I planned your liberty even before you get into the boundaries and the chains in your life. I've already planned the way I'm going to bring you out. So I want you to be fearless. Fear not, for God is working it out for you. Glory to God. You see, I want you to be fear-free and be faithful today. Be fear-free and be faithful, because God is working it out for you and you're going to win. Glory to God. Jeremiah chapter 29 and verse 11, the Bible says, I alone know the plan I have for you. Plan to bring you prosperity and not disaster. Plan to bring about the future you hope for. Glory to God. Because I know the plan I have for you. You see, my plan is to give you the exact thing you are desiring for. I will give you the exact thing you are hoping for. I will release that thing you are demanding for into your life. Amen. So God said, I have called you chosen. I have called you free. I have called you forgiven. I have called you desired. I have called you loved. And I have called you the adored. And everything I planned for you will come to pass. My plan is to give you the desires of your heart. My plan is to grant your expectation. Glory to God. So I want you to know that you are famous in the eyes of God. You are famous in the eyes of God. God has already decided it. Glory to God. It's already decided. You win. Glory to the Lamb of God. You see, I want you to believe this word and begin to speak it into your life, because God is bringing it through. He's bringing it through in the name of Jesus. You see, Isaiah chapter 41 verse 10, the Bible says, "Do not be afraid, I am with you. I am your God. Let nothing terrify you. I will make you strong and help you. I will protect you and save you." Come on, glory to God. "I will make you strong and help you. I will protect you and save you." So God is saying the outcome has already been decided. The result is already posted. I want you to believe it by faith. Don't see. God said, "I'm going to take you from where you used to be, and I'm going to take you into where you're supposed to be. I'm going to move you around. I'm going to move you from the place. I'm going to move you from the place you are to the place you're supposed to be. The shackles will be broken. The chains will be broken. And I decree a divine release right now. The chains are broken. The shackles are of your life. God is taking you to the place you have desired. God is taking you to the place of your expectation. Glory to God. I declare that into your life in the name of Jesus. Receive it by faith. Hallelujah." He said, "I'm going to do it in your life. I'm going to help you. It might look impossible, but I'm the God of all impossibilities." Glory to God. "I know how to work it out for you." Glory to God. Just believe it by faith. I said, "God, you say so, and I believe it. I'm going to say, I'm going to save you. I'm going to redeem you, and I'm going to deliver you. I'm going to bring you to that place so God's plan will come to pass in your life." Glory to God. You see, Genesis chapter 28 and verse 15, the Bible says, "Behold, I am with you and will keep you, careful watch over you and guard you wherever you may go. I will bring you back to this promised land, for I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you." This is the promise God gave to Abraham. "And remember, you are the seed of Abraham." The same promise God gave to Abraham, he gave you. Glory to God. By redemption, you have become a seed of Abraham. Glory to God. And God is saying the same thing to you. "I'm going to watch over your life." Glory to God. "Wherever you go, I'm going to be with you. You're not going to be defeated. I'm going to be with you. You're not going to die. I'm going to deliver you." I don't know what you're going through today, whether it's depression or addiction or pain or sickness or setback or attack in your life. I decree in your life that you are delivered right now. Everyone at the sound of my voice, I decree your liberty now in the name of Jesus. God is saying, "I'm going to bring you back to your promised land." Maybe you have derailed away from your purpose. Maybe you are far away from where you feel you're supposed to be now. God said, "I'm going to bring you back to the place I have destined for you." Glory to God. "And I will not leave you. I will not forsake you. All my promises to you will come to pass." Glory to God. Everything God has promised you, everything you feel, this belongs to me. God is saying, "I'm going to bring it back into your life." Glory to God. "I'm going to bring you back to your promised land, to that thing you want, that desires of your heart, because I'm going to make it work. I'm going to work it out. I'm going to make it work for you." Glory to God. See, "I will not leave you. I will not forsake you." So you are not forsaken. You are not forsaken. God got you covered from head to toe. You are not forsaken. God is with you. You are not alone in that battle. Your victory is today. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Your victory is now. You are not alone. You cannot lose. You are not alone. God is in your life. God is with you. And if God be for you, hallelujah, who can be against you? Who can stop you? Glory to God. Is it Romans chapter 8 and verse 32, the Bible says, "He who did not withhold or spare even his own son, but gave him up for us all, will he not also with him freely and graciously give us all other things?" If he did not spare his son, and he allowed his son to die for you, what is it that he can do for you? Glory to God. You see, God is giving you an open check today. Put anything you want him to do for you, put it down and begin to speak it. Because God is bringing it to pass in the next 30 days in your life. I decree that right now. In the next 30 days, you're going to have a breakthrough. In the next 30, before the next 30 days is over, everything you put on that paper and speak it, God will grant it in your life. Glory to God. God will bring it to pass in the, from now to the next 30 days. That will be a tremendous and amazing miracles and breakthroughs and healing and deliverances and promotion and increase in your life. I decree right now into your life in the name of Jesus. Write it down. God will do it in your life. Glory to God. Glory be to God. And God wanted to believe the word of God today. You see, they fear not because the outcome the outcome is already decided. It's posted. God got you covered. Victory is yours. You're going to win. And I declare it into your life today. And it will come to pass in the name of Jesus. Receive it by faith. I see the Lord doing exceedingly and abundantly and above all you can ever desire or imagine or think through his power that is at work in your life. This is IKEA saying, keep walking by faith. The Lord is in your life. Glory to God.